Hi everyone, so let me see some more examples based on your group. So here show that set of all real numbers of the form A star B into square 2 where A comma B belongs to Q is a group under addition. So solution for this is let R is equal to A plus B into square 2 and A comma B belongs to Q. So let x is equal to a1 plus b1 into square root 2 and y is equal to a2 plus b2 into square root 2 and z is equal to a3 plus b3 into square root 2. So here x, y, z belongs to R set of reals and a1, b1, a2, b2, a3, b3 belongs to Q, that is rationals. So closure law, for all x, y belongs to R, then x plus y belongs to R. So here x plus y is equal to a1 plus b1 into square root 2 plus a2 into b2 square root 2. So a1 plus a2 plus b1 plus b2 into square root 2. B1 plus b2 into square root 2. So if you add the value of a1, a2, b1, b2 by your rationals, then you get the resulting solution is belongs to R. Therefore closure law holds good. Next, associative law. For all x, y, z belongs to R, then x plus y plus z is equal to x plus y plus z. That implies that a1 plus a2 plus a3 is equal to b1 plus b2 plus b3 into square root 2. So this is equal to a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus b1 plus b2 plus b3 into square root 2. So if you add the value of a1, a2, a3, b1, b2, b3 and those are belongs to Q, if you substitute all those values here, this is equal to this. Okay, so therefore associative law holds. Next, identity law. E plus 0 is equal to 0 plus 0 into square root 2. So therefore E is equal to 0 belongs to R. Therefore identity law exists. Next, inverse law. For all x belongs to R, that implies that x is equal to what? A1 plus B1 into square 2 and that belongs to R. So here we have to take an inverse element as, so if you add those two elements that then we have to get the resulting solution is 0 because in inverse law, so there A plus minus of A is equal to 0. So here minus of A is what? Minus of x is equal to minus of A1 minus of b1 square 2 and that belongs to R such that x plus minus x is equal to 0. Therefore inverse law holds good. Hence A star B square root 2 form a group under addition. So next example is show that set Z is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta and theta belongs to R is an abelian group under multiplication. So let z is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta and theta belongs to R. So your cos theta plus I sin theta can be written as sis theta and your theta belongs to R. So here I take let A is equal to sis theta 1 and B is equal to sis theta 2 and C is equal to sis theta 3. For all ABC belongs to Z and theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 belongs to R. So closure law. For all A comma B belongs to Z, then A star B belongs to Z. That implies that A into B belongs to Z. So that implies that sis theta 1 into sis theta 2 belongs to Z. So this can be written as sis theta 1 plus theta 2 belongs to Z. And where theta 1 and theta 2 belongs to what? R. Therefore closure law holds. Next, associative law. For all A comma B comma C belongs to Z, then A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. So substitute the value of ABC, then you get sis theta 1 into sis theta 2 into sis theta 3 is equal to sis theta 1 into sis theta 2 into sis theta 3. So this can be written as sis theta 1 plus theta 2 into sis theta 3. So this is sis theta 1 into sis theta 2 plus sis theta 3. So that implies that sis theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 is equal to sis theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3. Therefore associative law holds. Next, identity law. So E is equal to 1. So this can be written as 1 plus I into 0 because your cos theta plus I sin theta is of the form your complex. So here I take identity element as 1. So that is equal to 1 plus I 0. Okay. So this is also belongs to Z. Therefore identity law holds. Next, inverse law. For all A belongs to Z, that implies that A inverse is equal to sis theta inverse. So this is equal to sys theta of minus 1, sys of minus theta. So that is belongs to G. So R for all A belongs to G, A into A inverse is equal to sys theta into sys theta inverse. So sys theta into sys of minus theta. So that is equal to sys of theta of minus theta is 0. That is sys 0. So sys 0 can be written as cos 0 plus I sin 0. So here the resulting solution is what? A1. So A into A inverse is equal to what? 1. So that is equal to what? E. So inverse law holds good. Next, fifth one is commutative law. So for all A comma B belongs to G, then A into B is equal to B into A. That implies that sys theta 1 into sys theta 2 is equal to sys theta 2 into sys theta 1. That implies that sys theta 1 plus theta 2 is equal to sys theta 2 plus sys theta 2 plus theta 1. So here theta 1 plus theta 2 is equal to theta 2 plus theta 1. So therefore, in the place of theta 2 plus theta 1, we replace theta 1 plus theta 2. Therefore, sys theta 1 plus theta 2 is equal to sys theta 1 plus sys theta 2. So G is an abelian group under multiplication. So next example is show that square root of unity is an abelian group with respect to multiplication. So here let G is equal to what? 1 and minus 1. So here I write a composition table, that is 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, minus 1 into 1 is minus 1, minus 1 into minus 1 is 1. So here closure law. So all the entries of elements in the table are in the set Z. Therefore, closure law holds good because no other elements exist other than Z. Therefore, here closure law holds good. Next, associative law. So consider 1 into 1 into minus 1 is equal to minus 1. So this is equal to 1 into minus 1, 1 into minus 1. So this is equal to what? Minus 1. This is equal to what? Minus 1. So 1 into 1 into minus 1 is equal to minus 1, and 1 into minus 1 is equal to also minus 1. Therefore, for all 1, 1, minus 1 belongs to Z. Therefore, here associative law holds good. Next, identity law. The row loaded by the element 1 is identical to top row. So the row 1 loaded by the element 1, so 1 minus 1, this is identical to what? 1 minus 1. Therefore, here 1 acts as an identity element and 1 belongs to what? Z. Inverse law. From the table, it is clear that here identity element is 1. So here 1 exists, so 1 inverse is 1. Next, minus 1, 1 here exists, so minus 1 inverse is what? Minus 1. Therefore, for all the elements, inverse exists, hence inverse law holds good. Next, commutative law. For all A comma B belongs to Z, then A star B is equal to B star A. That implies that 1 into minus 1 is equal to minus 1, and minus 1 into 1 also minus 1. Therefore, commutative law holds good. So therefore, here Z cross is an abelian group. So here, square root of unity form an abelian group with respect to multiplication. With this, I conclude my today's class. So if you have any doubts regarding this, you can send questions to my WhatsApp number and clarify your doubts. Thank you.